Aren't you, overstepping your authority a little?
Aren't I what?
Maybe you ought to just let them shoot each other and have done with it.
Tempt me, Chester.
I'm the one that needs a doctor.
You don't need a doctor, mister. You haven't got long to live.
What are you all? Related?
You're a peace officer. Don't you like peace?
He's been yelling like that for the last half hour. Says he wants to see you.
Wants to see me? What for?
Well, I don't know. We just, you know, I don't particularly much care.
If you run into any big words there, I'll be glad to pronounce them for you.
You decide how you want it, mister, hard or easy.
It's men like him that give jails a bad name.
Well, I can't sit around neglecting other patients waiting for you to get shot. You
might make more money that way.
I'll bet you if you tried to arrest her, she wouldn't even resist at all.
You really believe that?
No.
I sure am getting a belly full of you.
You don't have to take it.
What are you yammering about now?
All right, now you two.
It ain't gonna be easy with this shoulder.
Well, then why don't you just jump?
Mr. Harper here's came plumb from Baltimore. That's in
Maryland.
No, I just want to ask you a few questions about a man.
They're all bums.
So you found yourself a new lady friend, huh?
Huh?
Oh, I saw you out there with Mrs. Meigs. Not bad, huh?
Oh, Shaw.
And Spicer, you can either walk back, or about 5 minutes from now, you can start crawling if you're still able to move.
What?
You should have quit giving them drinks 3 hours ago.
I'm a barkeep, not a nursemaid.
You don't object to fishing, too, do you, Marshal?
Men like you, I object to your breathing.
You're dirt I wouldn't walk on.
Not very friendly, are you?
I'm not paid to be friendly.
A man's whole day can depend on how he gets it started off.
Well, if mine depended on how you started it off, mine wouldn't get started at all, and I'm getting ready to start mine. Ain't this the gall-dangedest weather you ever did see?
Oh, I don't know. I've seen gall-danger.
Look, will you do something for me?
Probably.
A potato.
A potato?
Yeah, a potato.
A potato?
I'll tell you, those cells out back there look like they've been used for a stable or something.
Well, they're good enough for any customers that we might have coming through here.
Man, be a fool not to carry a gun in a town like this, Matt.
Might be a worse fool to try and use it.
You like another beer?
Yeah.
Good, go in there and buy one for a change.
Twisting your head off, Mr. Dillon. What you're looking for just ain't here.
You seem awfully sure of that, Chester.
Miss Kitty's no words about.
Kitty? Well, I told you to stay off the streets.
You're always telling somebody something.
Hello, Molly.
I couldn't be in any trouble, Marshal. I just came to work.
You know, about 3 or 4 times a year, people come in here and try to kidnap me. That's why I leave that door unlocked. It saves time that way. Well, put that thing away. Come on, let's get my buggy.
Dan, throw a bucket of water on him, will you, Chester?
Yes, sir.
Well, you wouldn't understand it, but it's blood from a higher animal, a human, a monkey, something like that.
What is it?
Well, how long's it been since you've seen a monkey in Dodge?
Won't let him leave like that, Mr. Dillon?
Nope. Barney, do you trust me?
Sure I do, but...
All right, then just remember that when you wake up.
Well, you better get yourself hidden, Mr. Dillon. He'll open up on you right off there.
I'm hoping he'll be too surprised when he sees me here.
Well, I wouldn't count on that.
Stanley, I want to talk to you.
Surprise didn't stop him.
Nope.
Here's to the weaker sex.
Yeah, whichever one that is.
At least I had the decency to send a picture of my own sister.
Well, I don't have a sister. You mean you're going to charge me for just messing around a little and wrapping up my arms with a couple old rags?
Your bill just went up $1.
Huh?
And a quarter.
Chester, come on, you better come with me or you go broke around here.
Look, you, why don't you shove that grin in your pocket and take it on home?
The reason lightning rods are made out of metal is because the lightning goes down through the metal into the ground like it's supposed to. That's where it's trapped. Now, if there was wood, the wood would be just burnt to a cinder, I'll tell you that. And your tippy tip would, too.
He may not work fast, Chester, but he doesn't miss much.
Well, what's there to miss? I mean, it's just a shot man. I mean, a got shot man. I mean, he...
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Say, you're going to have a pretty busy day today. Land?
Why?
Low averages. You didn't do nothing yesterday.
What's your name, sonny?
The name's Dillon, Matt Dillon.
Diddle?
Dillon.
Diddle. Funny name.
Well, I declare, I just don't understand women at all. I mean, the very idea of crying at a wedding, it's just, I don't get the sense of it.
You know, I've been a doctor for an awful long time, and I've never been able to figure out why in thunder the stork always comes in the middle of the night.
Yeah, you're awful jocular this morning.
I'm what?
Jocular. That's a word. It is. You know, it just makes you feel kind of tingly thinking that maybe it could have happened.
Kind of what?
You know, tingly.
Oh, I don't... Tingly who? I'm going to my office so I don't get mixed up in any more of these inane conversations.
In what?
What do you mean, in what?
What you just said.
You're certainly cordial and effervescent today.
What?
Well, you're either up early or out late, one of the two.
Well, either way, I'm sober and unsatisfied. Would you just once let me make a simple observation about something? The weather, even though to you at the time it might appear to be inconsequential?
Why, in what?
What do you mean, in what?
What you just said.
What? I just said.
That's what I'm asking you.
No, thanks. Why don't you have one?
They're a pretty lively town, Cicero. Yeah, I mean, you know, later in the day.
Well, it was and it ain't.
What?
I'm sure glad you come, Marshal, because if you hadn't, I'm afraid I'd have had to take him myself.
You'd think a restaurant like this could afford a decent cook once in a while, wouldn't you?
Yeah, it's pretty bad, isn't it?
It's just terrible.
Not going to stop me from eating it, though.
No, me neither.
Sugar, Mr. Dillon?
No, thanks, Chester.
Well, I didn't mean did you want some. I meant that I wanted some.
Oh.
Just bend over and gaze at him fondly with the... Well, you know what I mean, hmm?
No, I don't.
You know, one of these days, I might get a chance to work on you.
Oh, no, sir. Oh, I couldn't stand that. I'd sooner die out on the prairie in the snow, all alone, bleed to death in the snow. Nobody around to bury me.
Now, how did you get out in the snow, anyway? Chester, there's no figuring a woman.
Yeah. We're mighty grateful to you, me and Medora. Especially Medora.
Yeah, I know, in her condition.
Let me see now. Yes, you can be looking fierce and drawing your guns. Yeah, what's the idea? You're supposed to have two guns, one in each hip. Why haven't you?
Well, I tell you, Jacoby, it only takes one bullet to kill a man, you know, and it only takes one gun to fire it.
Nonsense. I've seen pictures.
All right, then, I keep the other hand free so I can blow my nose when I'm working.
Tell exactly everything about how a man feels to look into his eyes.
Look at me, Dillon.